what you need to. But he's also a very headstrong person. And it can be difficult to reason with him at times. So I'm a little worried.
You know, anytime you make a transition in your mind, it always seems insane. You know, uprooting him may cause a little bit of a setback. You're talking about transitioning him to another state, talking about new friends, new environments, and then the cost for doing that.
I just gotta fight. I feel like in my situation, I feel like my daddy didn't fight, so I don't want to be that parent that don't fight.
I understand.
So that's why I was like, it took a while for me to stop resenting him. And I know everyone needs to resent me.
I just want you to know, I'm on your side. You just have to make sure that if he goes with you, you're ready to take on that extra responsibility.
What does it take to be the best? Never letting failure stand in your way. When others go home, you're just getting started. You're driven by the dream. So all of the sacrifices, the endless hours of dedication, it culminates on stage, a world of dance.
A world of dance, during any time, and Sundays on NBC.
Introducing the new high-rise rock star with Never Quit Shape Retention. Your favorite fit now holds its shape and hugs in all the right places, wear after wear. Hurry into Old Navy this Friday through Sunday to get 40% off everything, in-store and online.
I'm here for my denim tune-up.
That's 40% off everything, in-store and online at Old Navy.
Examine here, and we'll sit down and talk a little bit about the context and what I think we can do, okay?
Okay.
Great. Okay. Okay, so one thing I did notice, though, is in the back of your throat, the tonsil area, that part of the back of the uvula, and the back of the throat, is a little low compared to where your tongue is. So what we call that is a melon petty score of about 3 to 4. That's what people have a big open back of the airway look like, and that's what we call a melon petty 1. When the tongue and the soft palate, where the uvula is that thing that hangs down the back of your throat, when they get a little closer, that's called a class 2. And you can see in class 3, it's even closer. In class 4, you don't see a distinction between the two.
Which one is hers?
She's right between these two. So she's over in this end of the pool. And that puts her at higher risk for having things like CPAP. Mm-hmm. Okay? So that, along with the symptoms that you mentioned, really make me think that that's potentially a problem for you. So for many years, people can snore and have sleep apnea and not know it, and develop hypertension over time, and develop diabetes, or even develop obesity and heart disease and strokes. These are things that actually happen when sleep apnea is untreated. So it's really important that we find people before what's happening to them. The way to determine is to do an overnight sleep test. So that's our next step for you. Okay?
I am not looking at